I've seen. Camilla. What was her surname? Farang. I remember her parents making a desperate appeal on the front page of most of the national dailies. They're divorced now. The strain was too much. Yes. And the circumstances. There was something not right about this case from the start. There still is, for that matter. It hasn't been cleared up.
What was the problem?
I'll try and stick to what I know. Camilla was put to bed after watching children's TV and having supper, and before the TV news, so 7:30 at the latest. At some point during the news, she called for her mother, who went in to talk to her. At around 7:45, she calculated. She poked her head around the door one more time at 8:45 approximately. She was asleep by then. And that was the last time anyone we spoke to saw of little Camilla.
Okay, well, that's what I remember. What usually happens in cases like this is that the child wanders away from the house and doesn't return home, right?
Exactly.
So the investigation concentrated on the situation at home.
It did. But let's keep to the facts. The mother discovered her daughter was missing when she decided to turn in herself at 11:20. She checked the bedroom to make sure her daughter was sleeping as sweetly as before, but her bed was empty. At first, of course, she thought she'd gone to the loo, but she wasn't there either. The bedrooms in these houses are on the ground floor, and there's a door from the child's room to a patch of garden behind the house. This door was open.
Open?
Yes.
Any signs of a break-in?
No.
But it must have been locked.
Probably, but the mother wasn't sure. They may have forgotten to close the top catch, because Camilla often used this door when she went out to play.